This is الله يعني الله المستعان. طيب نعم. So because Allah عز وجل has made Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم the seal of all prophets, and this is something that we all agree to, alhamdulillah, otherwise you're no longer a Muslim. And the message has to remain upon earth. The message of Islam has to remain, because in the previous times the message may have been gone, but Allah Azza wa Jal would send another prophet or another messenger with a new revelation. So something was always there for the people, so they will not have an excuse on the day of judgment. Afwan. The fact that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger, the final messenger, and there will be none coming after him, his message cannot go away. And this is something very important that we need to know in terms of da'wah. Because I usually, personally, I take new Muslims from our da'wah center, walaikum salam, every Monday to the court after they embrace Islam and they learn the basics of Islam. After 1 month, we take him to court so they can give him an official certificate. Fadal, yes, fadal. We can give him an official certificate of becoming Muslims. And I ask him on the way there in the bus, it's part of my job in the da'wah center, I ask him some questions to see where they are. And very often I ask him, we start with the messengers. What is the miracle of Nuh? Oh, the ark and the ship. What's the miracle of Ibrahim? Allah threw him in the fire, didn't burn him. What's the miracle of Musa? The stick. What's the miracle of Jesus? Giving life to the dead by the will of Allah. What's the miracle of Muhammad? No answer. Ya akhwan, what's the miracle of Muhammad? No answer. Every occasion somebody says splitting the moon. And this is very dangerous. Huh? What do you mean? The miracle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is this man? And it's a very special miracle. Why? Because if you, this, so you will use this in future, inshallah, in da'wah. Ya akhi, you're dealing with an atheist. Somebody who doesn't believe in God. You tell him, you know Moses split the ocean? He tell you, yeah, yeah. He'll say, have you ever seen it? You have it on camera? Say, no. He says, well, how do you believe? Say, I believe. He says, you crazy, man. You believe anything people say? Huh? I tell you that maybe 10 years ago, 100 years ago, people said that the devil came to earth and he conquered the whole sky and he was cooking steak. And people say this. You believe it? You say, no. He say, why? The people say it. You say, yeah, but he can corner you. The bottom line, he can put you in the corner. Because at the end of the day, you could say, I have faith. To him, you're crazy. Because you haven't seen anything. So you're believing in nonsense. Now this is, so why? The miracles of the prophets died with them. Only those who seen it with their own eye are those who can test to it. Otherwise, those who came after, they can only believe based on faith. But we have never seen it, yet we believe. To an atheist, that doesn't make any sense. Now, if they want to do the same thing against Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they cannot do the same. They say, no, you don't need to see what he did. I have the miracle with me now. Come to my house. Let's go to a bookstore. This is the miracle of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You don't need to have a video camera. You don't need to be there to see it. Now, Allah challenged you in this Quran, first and foremost, to come up with one small chapter just for me. 10 verses, 10 words. Surah Al-Kawthar. Huh? إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأكثر. 10 words. Allah says, إن كنتم في ريب مما نزلنا على عبدنا فأتوا بسورة من مثله. If you are in doubt about what we have revealed upon our servant, come with one chapter like it. The smallest chapter is the Kawthar. Say, please, take 10 years, learn Arabic. And then just write one chapter for me like the Quran. This is the challenge. When you meet this challenge, then we could say, okay, this is not from Allah. Until you do so, you cannot prove otherwise. Because it's upon you to negate it. Find a contradiction between Islam and science, between the Quran and any scientific fact about the human embryo or this, anything in the Quran and science, will not be able to do so. So the miracle of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam remained after his death. Because he's the final prophet. His miracle is not like the miracles of the other prophets, a stick or something that you can no longer see. Rather, his miracle has to live after him. So no one will have an excuse on the Day of Judgment. I never met Muhammad. I wasn't there. I wasn't living in the desert. I was living in Greece. I was living in China. No excuse. This is what you were supposed to follow. had, whether you seen him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or you haven't seen him. What he was given as from Allah remained after him. So all this is involved in this particular subject matter, that Allah will protect this deen. And Islam has to remain for the creation. Why? As the Shaykh says, because otherwise people will have an excuse on the Day of Judgment with Allah. They will say, I didn't get anything. Islam was all innovations and there was no truth in it. No. Allah has always assigned someone to expose them. وَإِذَا كَانَتْ الرِّسَالَ لَابُدْ أَن تَبْقَى فِي الْأَرْضِ لَزِمَا أَن يُقَيِّدَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ نَعَمْ. So the Shaykh says, if the message was to remain upon earth, then it becomes compulsory that Allah Azza wa Jal will assign someone بمقتدى حكمته عند كل بدعة من يبينها ويكشف عورها وهذا هو الحاصل. So it is from the wisdom of Allah Azza wa Jal that for every innovation there will be someone who will expose it and he will show the issue, the problem with it. And this is the bottom line. ولهذا أقول لكم دائما احرصوا على العلم. Now the Shaykh is advising his students, because this book, by the way, was not written. This book was delivered in tafsir of the Shaykh. Then his students are the ones who transcribed it into the book. So the Shaykh said to his students, that's why I advise you, be keen on knowledge. Be keen on seeking knowledge. We need knowledge in this particular day. لأننا في هذا البلد في المستقبل في مستقبل إذا لم نتسلح بالعلم المبني على الكتاب والسنة فيوشك أن يحل بنا ما حل في غيرنا من البلاد الإسلامية. And this is a fact, wallahi. The Shaykh rahimahullah said, because we are in this particular country, he's speaking at the Mamlaka, Saudiya, in the future, if we are not armed with knowledge of the Quran and the Sunnah, we are about to suffer from what the other Muslim countries have suffered from. And you see what the other Muslim countries have suffered from. If you go to India, you see people go into a grave and they do sujood. Man with a big lihya, big beard, you think he's the sheikh of the mashayikh, going on the ground, making sujood, throwing a letter to a dead person in the grave. If we don't have knowledge of the Quran and the Sunnah, then this may happen here. And we seek refuge in Allah from that. وَهَذَا الْبَلَدُ الْآنِ هُوَ الَّذِي يُرَكِّزُ عَلَيْهِ أَعْدَاءِ الْإِسْلَامِ وَيُسَلِّطُونَ عَلَيْهِ سِهَامِهِمْ. He says, and this country is the one that all the enemies of Islam are focusing on now. And they are pointing their arrows towards it. مِنْ أَجْلَ أَنْ يُضِلُّوا أَهْلَهُ. In order to misguide the people here. فَلِذَلِكَ تَسَلَّحُوا بِالْعِلْمِ حَتَّى تَكُونُوا عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ مِنْ أَمْرِ دِينِكُمْ. That's why I advise you to arm yourself with knowledge. So you'll be upon clear knowledge, clear evidence regarding your deen. وَحَتَّى تَكُونُوا مُجَاهِدِينَ بِأَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَقْلَامِكُمْ لِأَعْدَاءِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. In order for you to become mujahideen, those who strive with your tongues and with your pens against the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And يعني this is, by the way, among the ways, just as an addition from me, not from the book. The enemies of Islam now, they're trying to make it into here through the satellite dish. This satellite dish that the people have taken very lightly, يعني the epitome of shirk and innovations are in what they present to the people. Even the simplest seeming cartoon. When you think of this cartoon, you know, you think it's just for the children, Disney and not Disney, let the child watch the Little Mermaid and, you know, Beauty and the Beast and as-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah and what have you. You know what the Little Mermaid concept is all about? The Little Mermaid, what is it about? You think it's just a cool cartoon, huh? Look how much evil is in it. You're talking about a half-naked woman who's wearing only a bra and the rest of her body is a fish. Now, we're not worried about the fish part. We're worried about the upper part. Huh? With her makeup under the water, somehow she has full hair and makeup. Her concept is to run away from her father, which is disobedience, عقوق الوالدان, huh? To disobey the parents in order to fall in love with the man who lives on the surface of earth. That's really what it's about. And everything else is just little nonsense. In order to send this kind of mentality and ideology to the children who watch and get brainwashed. So when they reach the age of 16, even indirectly, they don't have to think of the Little Mermaid. Their mind works in a fashion where I want to fall in love with X-Men. And why do I have to wear this hijab? And I do things behind my father's back. And I mistreat my father. I run away from him. And the parents wonder, what happened to my children? I thought they were doing salah. I thought they used to fast in Ramadan. Why? Because the essence of tarbiyah, the raising of the children, they were raised by the TV. And they were raised by the kuffar. And the kuffar, they're not dumb. They know what they're doing. They know how to bring you the poison and the cake. He doesn't come and tell you, I have one kilo of poison. You want to come and die with me? He won't say no, thank you. He will tell you, look at this delicious cake that I have here. And he'll put the poison inside. So you come, oh, mashallah, tabarakallah, then he kills you anyways. We need to be more mindful of that. And we need to be, I mean, if you have children, it's a serious affair, wallah. So now they're trying to destroy this country through this particular concept. And so the youth over here are trying to imitate يعني, the non-Muslims. And we have in the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam the best example. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنٌ. We have in the Messenger of Allah the best example. They're trying to misguide the youth over here. So they're no longer concerned about the Quran and the Sunnah. Their main concern is Tupac and Biggie Smalls and 50 Cent and all these rappers and singers and artists and actors who are the garbage of people. These are the people where their whole life is drugs and alcohol and fornication and haram and lying and cursing and yeah, they're evil people, man. But these are the examples of the youth. So if you have a satellite dish and you have a light and some gasoline, Allah will reward you. And turn on the Ida'at al-Quran al-Kareem or get some sort of beneficial knowledge for the children. Make them a nice little library at home of nice interesting stories. It does, yani they're not going to be memorizing fiqh books. They're children, but there's interesting Islamic material that we could raise our children so they could defend this deen. Because somebody has to defend this deen. If it's not us, Allah will assign someone else. So we only try to partake of the, yani get a slice of the pizza, as they say. Allah will defend this deen with us or without us. It's a given. You either take part and be in, yani wise, or you sit back and watch the people do it. And you'll be among the losers. وكل هذه البدع انتشرت بعد الصحابة فالصحابة رضوان الله عليهم لم يكونوا يبحثون في هذه الأمور لأنهم يتلقون الكتاب والسنة على ظاهرهما وعلى ما تقتضيه الفطرة والفطرة السليمة سليمة. He said all these innovations only were spread into Islam after the time of the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم excuse me, because the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم may Allah be pleased with them, they used to not debate or argue and go into these affairs. They would not go into these affairs of we accept this to Allah, but we do not accept that. Only the things that the mind accept, we accept. The things that the mind accept, doesn't accept. Only the affirming, we reject. The negation, you know what I'm saying? We accept. They did not go into all of that. Why? Because they were accepting the Quran and the Sunnah according to the apparent meaning. According to the clear meaning as it was revealed. And what the natural inclination, fitra, the way Allah created us. And their fitra was, al-fitra salima salima, and salima, yani the sound. The sound inclination is sound. Yani what they mean by sound, not the sound, is something that is well. It's good. There's no deficiency in it. That's what is intended by sound. You know what I'm saying? You have a sound heart. Meaning a heart that is free from diseases. It doesn't mean the sound of hearing. This is a technical English term.
It sounds good. Like, it sounds good.
Not that one. Yeah, not that one. Not the one that means it sounds good. Rather they say, I'm safe and sound. Somebody gets in a car accident, huh? And this is English language now. We're dealing with the English. Exactly. So they say, how are you? You say, I'm safe and sound. Safe. Meaning I'm well. Nothing has harmed me. That's what is intended by sound. So their fitrah was sound. There was nothing busted in it like those people came. لكن أتى هؤلاء المبتدعون فابتدعوا في دين الله تعالى ما ابتدعوا. He said, but those innovators came and they innovated into the religion of Allah what they have innovated. إما لقلة علمهم, either because of their lack of knowledge, their deficiency in knowledge, أو لقصور فهمهم, or because their lack of understanding or their deficiency in understanding, أو لسوء قصدهم, or because of their evil intent. فأفسدوا الدنيا بهذه البدع. So they have corrupted this dunya, this world, with their innovation التي ابتدعوها, that they have innovated. ولكن كما قلنا إن الله تعالى بحكمته وحمده ومنته وفضله ما من بدعة